Daytime baseball here on MLB Network. Lots of pink all around for this Mother's Day matchup between the Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim and the Baltimore Orioles. Live baseball here on MLB Network, and it comes your way next. Keegan Aiken gets the ball for the Orioles in this one. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, you take a look at that ERA. That's a little bloated right now. This guy's a better pitcher than that, but he hasn't been real consistent. One good game, one bad game. I think what he needs to do, if he can string together three or four good quality games in a row, that ERA will start creeping back down. He definitely needs to start pitching a lot better than he has up to this point. And it'll be interesting to see if he can turn it around in this one.
Underway now in the Sunday finale as the first pitch today is taken for strike one. Well, guys, these Orioles entering play today. They've been hot of late, winners in four straight.
Yeah, Matty, without question. They find themselves in this position today. They got a chance to sweep the series on Sunday and make it a miraculous weekend.
Boy, Dero, it's always a nice way to finish off a weekend. You win a big game on Saturday, and to close it off with a win here and a sweep on Sunday would really be sweet for this ball club.
Should be a picture-perfect afternoon for baseball. 78 degrees at first pitch. Line to the right side. Therefore, it is Mancini, and that's the first out of the inning. So coming to the plate, David Fletcher, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. The pitch. And set up behind the plate is Joe McDonald, as you see the rest of our umpiring crew in this one.
Hey, Joe McDonald, he's a tough guy to figure out sometimes, D-Ro. One inning, he'll be given that inside corner. The next inning, he doesn't give much of that inside corner. His zone fluctuates a lot.
You know, Dan, you could see some definite confusion on the face of some hitters today. Questioning in the strike zone. One pitch is a strike on the outer half. The next time, it's a ball. Kind of a little cat and mouse with the umpire when you should be focused on the pitcher.
The third baseman, number six, Anthony Rendon.
So bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring up Anthony Rendon. First pitch of the at bat. Hit to third. Offline throw, but a good job of getting back to the bag as the side is retired. Angels are gone in order. And now the O's will get their first crack at it. No score. Felix Pena gets the ball in game three of the series. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, he wasn't all that bad in his last one, pitching into the sixth inning to pick up the win. We'll see if he can go a little bit deeper in this one.
So stepping in, Jose Iglesias. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Oriole, not shortstop.
Now the pitch. And this is low, ball one. These Angels, as they enter play here this afternoon, fellas, fair to say they're not playing their best baseball right now. Losers of five of their last six.
Yeah, guys, anytime you start a road trip, first five games you start 1-4, you're just trying to salvage. Do the fundamental things right. Try and sneak out a couple wins, get on the plane, and get out of here.
Pujols has a play. He's got it one away.
The second baseman, Ramon Urias.
Now at the plate, Ramon Urias, hitless in four tries in the ball game yesterday. First delivery to him on the way. Lays off 1-0. Urias, the native of Mexico, this is his first year at the big league level. Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call.
Boy, you don't see that very often out of a rookie. That's a 2-0 count, and both of those pitches were really close. This guy has a pretty good eye.
Hit to first. Pujols has it. And he'll step on first himself for the out.
Batting third. The right fielder. Trey Mancini.
Stepping up now, Trey Mancini. First cuts for him here with the bases open and two away. Here's the pitch.
At the ball.
Hey, you want to talk about being in a zone? This guy's been raking lately, and it all starts with his pitch selection. Two great takes, and he's almost daring the pitcher just go ahead and challenge him.
And here's a fastball for a strike. 2-1 now. Here it comes.
I don't blame him for not coming over the heart of the plate. He circled this guy on the lineup card when he got to the yard today. He's been swinging one of the hotter bats in the game.
Bases are empty here with two men out. A bouncer to the left side. Rendon is there. Low throw, but a nice play at the bag by Pujols saves an error and ends the inning. An inning in the books tonight, still scoreless here on MLB Network. And that'll bring Mike Trout to the dish. He's got three hits in six tries for the series. Wow. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. Second inning starts with a fastball that misses. It's 1-0. And he watches one miss outside. 2-0 now. And now a pitch on the way. And he gets this fastball over. It's 2-1. Three and one.
They know the threat this guy possesses at the plate. I know it's 3-1 in this situation right here, but I can't imagine anything comes over the heart of the plate.
Lined hard to center field. And that finds the outfield grass for a base hit. He'll get it into second, and he'll get in there safely.
As we take a look at the replay here, you can see that it was a hanging changeup. Nice job of staying back on it, and he's able to tattoo it for a double. And you know, if that pitch would have supplied more velocity, it might have been out of here. He hit it right on the screws.
Here's Tommy La Stella now, and he'll hit with a chance to push across the game's first run.
Yeah, great RBI opportunity here, but at the very least, he needs to find a way to advance that runner to third. Small things like that in a tight game can make a big difference.
From the stretch. Hit out toward second. Scooped up. And there's one down now.
That is good. The left fielder, number 8. Justin Upton.
Stepping into the box, Justin Upton. And as you can tell easily from the splits, he's really struggled away from their home ballpark. First pitch coming. Here it is.
1-0.
Trout takes his lead at third with one away. A 2-0 count to the Angels left fielder.
This would seem like an easy RBI situation. 2-0 count, runner in scoring position, but you have to know there's an open base and he might be pitching around you.
From the stretch. 3-0 now.
Well, we all know he's not the greatest threat with the bat up there. His numbers certainly aren't that pretty. But, hey, I give him credit. He's really working the count right here.
The 3-0 pitch is in there for strike one.
Stealing that strike on 3-0 was important, but you don't want to miss over the heart of the plate in this situation. I got to believe he's going to be way more aggressive right here.
Three and one, here it is. No score here as we play inning number two. Count remains full. Another full count pitch home. And that misses ball four. So with one out, that'll at least set up the double play possibility here that could get them out of the inning.
I'm sure the manager is fine with that. He tried to entice him with that 3-2 pitch, but he didn't take the bait. First base was open, though, so he just needs to make a good pitch for a ground ball.
In now, Brian Goodwin, and their runners at the corners now. First pitch of the at-bat on its way.
Jumped ahead with strike one there, and that's something he's going to do a lot of in this start. He doesn't have lights out stuff, so it's important for him to be pitching ahead and have the hitters on their heels.
Set to deliver the 0-1.
Big pitch coming up right here. He'd love for a ground ball or a strikeout.
Runners are at the corners with one man out. Fouled away. Ready with another 0-2. And this is on the ground to first. Could be two. To Iglesias for one. Relay to first in time. And just like that, the side is retired. So no runs here on a base hit, no errors, and one man left aboard. We'll go to the bottom half of inning number two. And we are tied 0-0. Settling in now, Renato Nunez. He's got hits in each of the last five ball games.
The third baseman, Renato Nunez.
First offering on its way. Nunez, a 6'1" right-handed swinger and thrower. He's a 5-year vet at the major league level. The 1-1 is looked at for ball number two. Maybe a favorable call there, taken for a strike. Two balls, two strikes, a crucial count for both pitcher and hitter. So, Dan, what was your approach on the mound in that count? Do you still pitch for the strikeout here?
Action pitch right here, 2-2. The last thing you want to do is to fall behind the count 3-2.
So he ran the fastball by him for the punch out. Renato Nunez sent packing to begin the bottom of the inning. At the plate now, Dwight Smith Jr. As he'll try to hold back on the swing, but he went around for the first strike. The average not quite where he wants it, down in the 220s. Four home runs and 19 driven in. And that misses 1-1. Bottom of the second here with no score. This one's outside, quite a bit off the plate that time. Now the 2-1. Weakly hit towards first, right to him. And he'll step on first for the out, three unassisted.
Well executed two-seamer on the outside corner that time. And that's what you'll get a lot of with that pitch. He rolled right over it.
Anthony Santander the next to bat. Two hits and eight tries for the series. Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. And a fastball, close but ultimately ruled a ball, 1-0. And now pitch on the way. Not surprisingly here, this is on the ground to the right side. Throw to Pujols is going to be in time, and the inning is over. Three up, three down for the Orioles, who move to the third with no score. Here's Albert now. Day off for him yesterday, but back out there for this one.
The first baseman, Albert Pujols.
First pitch on its way.
Ball, that's out.
Now the 1-0. Misses, ball two. Now the 2-0 home. Finds the zone, strike one.
Gutsy pitch right there. 2-0 changeup for a strike. Good call by the catcher. Great execution by the pitcher.
And here's a ball hit in the air. And no one will track it down. Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch.
You do not want to walk the 8-hole hitter. It just opens up so many options. Do we bunt them over to second with the 9-hole hitter? Do we try and play for that big rally with the top of the order coming up? This is a huge pitch. You can't allow this guy to walk.
And a great pitch there as Pujols swings and misses, and it's always a sigh of relief when you can set him down.
Well, I have to give credit to him on the mound for not letting that previous pitch get to him. He wanted it, but he didn't get the call. But I love how he didn't let it affect him, and he comes right back with another good pitch and gets the punch out.
Jason Castro, the catcher, is in. And look out as that fastball ran in and got him. Ouch, bang.
Well, no one really likes getting plunked by a pitch, but as long as it doesn't do too much damage, most guys will take it any day. A free pass can be a big deal if the guys behind you can make it hurt for the pitcher.
So now to the plate will be Andrelton Simmons. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. First offering on its way.
At the ball. Count 1-0.
Third inning, no score to this point. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
Hey, always a good idea to take a couple of pitches when you're facing a young arm like this one. And now he's put himself in a real good hitter's count.
Now the 2-0 home.
Not the ideal location for a changeup up in the zone, but he got away with it.
All even now, 2-2. And another foul ball. Runners on first with one down. There's a swing and a high pop up. Nunez moving to his left, and he makes the catch for the second out.
The batter number 22, second baseman, David Fletcher.
And now for the Angels, David Fletcher, 0-for-1 here in the early going. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Now a slider, and he gets ahead of him here, 0-1. Hit on the ground down the first baseline, but this will be a foul ball as he's behind 0-2 now. Hit on the ground to third. Fielded cleanly. On to second for the force out, and the side is retired. Angels leave one. Home half of the third coming up. No score.
Welcome back. As the Orioles look to get the offense going here in the third, this is a lineup that has had its struggles this season. At the start of the day, they find themselves as one of the worst teams in the league in hitting the long ball and scoring runs. I talked to one player before the game that told me he thinks things have sort of snowballed on them this year. They didn't get off to a good start, and since then, most everyone has simply been searching for answers and trying to do too much. He admitted it's been a frustrating year, but they have to keep pushing forward and looking for better ways to generate offense. Back to you guys.
All right, thanks, Heidi.
Hey!
He's ready. Here's the first offering. He'll hold off on the slider to start the at-bat. It's ball one. The 1-0. Misses for the second ball.
It's never advantageous to fall behind 2-0 as a pitcher, but if you're going to do it, it's far better to do it with a guy down in the bottom of the order. Time for a challenge fastball right here, though.
And the Orioles have their first hit of the game.
Batting it. The catcher. Austin.
Stepping up to the plate, Austin wins. He's set. Here it comes. And here's a called strike at the knees. Don't think he liked that one too much, but it's 0-1. Has a look, now the pitch. Check swing, but he held up in time. Ball one. Now the 1-1 pitch. Swing and a liner. Oh, and this kicks right off of him. Simmons.
Batting ninth. The first baseman. Chris Davis.
Ready now, Chris Davis. Not the shiniest of batting average as he comes in hitting down in the 220s for the year. Here comes the first pitch. A ball and no strikes. Bottom of inning number three, nothing, nothing, our score. Runs outside, so it goes to 2-0 now. From the stretch. And the fastball is off his glove, and it gets away. And that'll move the runner up to second as it takes away the double play possibility.
Looked like a four-seamer that just kept rising on him, and he couldn't get the mitt up in time to catch it. Really no excuse for that. That'll go as a pass ball, and deservedly so.
One out and a runner on second base. Three and one. The 3-1 pitch finds the zone to fill the count, 3-2. Now he spins on one here and drives it to deep right field. Into the bleachers and gone. A two-run shot for Chris Davis, number 299 in his career, as the Orioles are now out to a 2-0 lead. The shortstop now, Jose Iglesias, as he'll take a look at a high strike that time. It's nothing in one. He popped out in his first trip. And there's a fastball well off the plate inside. Swing and a ground ball to third. Reined in. And a throw to Pujols is in time for the second out.
Now back, second baseman, Ramon Urias.
So striding forward now, Ramon Urias. First delivery to him on the way. Two out, nobody on. Oh, and this at bat is quickly moving from bad to worse. It's 0-2 now.
Have to find a way to take a deep breath right here and regroup. I know the umpire missed one, but you can't allow the next couple of pitches to be dictated by one bad call. Find a way.
Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. The 1-2. Line drive to center field. And that's a base hit. 1-for-2 in his first couple of plate appearances. So good work on a 1-2 count to get on base. So now time will be called as we're going to get a visit from the pitching coach here as he'll hope to settle this guy down. And here's the big right-handed power threat, Trey Mancini, as he'll cut on and miss it. A good slider at the knees for strike one. A runner on first with two away. And here's a foul ball just off to the right as they get ahead of him here. Nothing in two. Just off the outside as he can't catch the corner.
Step out of the box, take a deep breath. After spitting on that changeup, you might have bought yourself a fastball.
Here's the 1-2. Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch the bottom of the zone. Set to deal on 2-2. pulled high in the air out to left field. Upton's under it. And the inning is over. The sights and sounds of a day at the ballpark. Oh, my goodness. More to come on MLB Network Sunday Baseball after this. All set for the start of the inning, and digging in next will be Anthony Rendon. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
Hey, we're still in the early stages of this one. They're only down by a couple of runs, but it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
Pitcher wants to have a quick inning right here, capitalize on the momentum his batters have.
The windup and the 0-1. Grounded back up the middle. Throw to first in time. One gone here in the fourth.
The center fielder.
So with that, let's call on the guys in the graphics department to put up the pitch speed comparison for the two starters. And both guys bringing it pretty good. A couple of matching 94s as the two top speeds thus far. So now the Angels cleanup batter, Mike Trout. It was a double for him in his first turn at the plate.
Yeah, he did a great job to go down and get that one his last at bat. But I got to think they're going to pitch him up, maybe elevate something in the zone. Interested to see how he approaches this next AB.
No balls and a strike to count. No runs, just one hit, and no errors to this point for the Angels. Changeup gets him out in front for strike two. Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there.
As a hitter, you got to be staunch in your game plan. You know he has a nasty changeup, and you got to fight to make sure it's in the zone. That's a great take right there.
Hit hard back up the middle. Scooped up. On to Davis at first, and there are two away.
The batter, number nine, designated hitter, Tommy Lasella.
Next will be the designated hitter, Tommy Lasella. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. First pitch of the at bat on its way. Hard hit ball to second. Throw on to Davis, takes care of him, and that'll end the inning. Angels go down 1-2-3. They're still down. It's 2-0. Welcome back to Baltimore as we send you down to check in with Heidi Watney.
Matt, I had a chance to discuss the state of the Orioles offense with their manager between innings. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. It's still pretty early in the game, but they've seen a lot of pitches already. And he thinks the two runs they've pushed across so far is just the beginning, given the quality of the at-bats they're putting together.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Renato Nunez. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
First offering on its way. And, oh, looked inside, but that's ruled a strike. Nothing in one. And he lays off for ball one. Just behind the fastball there, two strikes now.
So far in this game, he's the only guy in the lineup that's gone down on strikes.
This is the only guy in the lineup that struck out so far, and Now he finds himself in the hole with two strikes.
Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out.
This has not been a weekend to remember for him. He's just been completely lost at the plate, flailing all over the place. Now that's his sixth strikeout of the series. They've really got him figured out.
Into the box now, Dwight Smith Jr. Swung on but fouled off to the left. Set to deliver the 0-1. Snatched out of midair at first base for out number two.
The left fielder, number 25, Anthony Santander.
Digging in, the switch hitter, Anthony Santander, comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. Santander, a 25-year-old, he's in his fourth season as a major league player. Two runs, three hits, and no errors for the Orioles so far. Into the corner and slicing foul. A windup and the 0-2 pitch. Tried to get him to go after one below the knees, but it's 1-2.
Well, there's the classic 0-2 wasted fastball. Not even close to the zone. We'll see what he throws on the next pitch.
The 1-2. Swing and a drive to right. There it goes. Into the flag court and gone. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. Fourth home run for him on the season, and the Orioles have now taken a 3-0 lead.
Well, how do you beat the shift? You hit it over the shift, of course. You can't play guys up in the sky, so he lifts this one up and out of here.
Austin Hayes the next to bat. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. A base hit in his first trip. And a fastball in there for a strike, 1-1. And now a fastball, but he's able to hold off on it, and it's 2-1 now. Bases are empty here with two men out. And it's two balls and two strikes now. Pops this one up, but this will land untouched. Drilled to the right side, and that's through for a hit.
Up next to Loria, the catcher, Austin Wynn.
Now a throw over to first. And he'll get dirty, but he's back in safely. Into the box, Austin wins as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. 0-for-1 with a run scored thus far. The 0-1 pitch. Called strike 0-2.
Well, you can see he's coming right at this guy, just pounding the ball in the strike zone. He certainly has the advantage now. This guy hasn't even swung the bat yet.
Oh, got him looking at the two-seamer, and that'll end it. Orioles add on thanks to the solo home run. We played four. It's now 3-0 Baltimore. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Matt, I had a chance to discuss the state of the Angels offense with their manager between innings.
And flat out, he told me they just need to put better swings on the ball right now. He said they've been frustrated hitting into ground out after ground out, but it's up to them to adjust. They know they're getting a lot of pitches down in the zone, so they either need to learn to lay off or find a way to get under those pitches a little bit more, because clearly the balls on the ground aren't benefiting them in this one.
Leading off with
okay,
the
thank you, Heidi.
The left fielder, number 8, Justin Upton.
Put him away!
First pitch on its way to Upton. Way inside with that one, a pretty easy take there. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two.
Hey, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, that's right where you want to miss. Any lower, and he'll probably make you pay for it.
Now the 2-0 home.
Hey.
Great job on those last two pitches of varying speeds. Gave him a hard fastball, and then he locked him up with a changeup.
Upton lays off again, and he's in control of the count. It's 3-1.
Hey, throwing the ball great up until this point. Don't want to allow a leadoff walk. Needs to just focus in on his mechanics right here.
And a good eye here as he takes ball four, and it's a base on balls to lead off the fifth inning.
Well, they haven't been able to scratch a run across yet, so maybe this walk will jumpstart their offense a little bit.
Digging in for his second at bat, Brian Goodwin. Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Change up. A little bit inside. 1-0. A runner at first with no outs here. Line toward the alley in left center. That's his first base hit. Making one for two now.
Boy, that's something you see often in batting practice. Guys using the whole field there, D-Row. I like to see that. A lefty that's just not always pull happy.
100%, Dan, that pitchers have gotten so much nastier in today's game that if you're not willing to play with the entire field, you're going to struggle.
Standing in now, Albert Pujols, as he'll take a called strike here on a borderline pitch at strike one. Looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat. A little quick on that swing, and he finds himself behind 0-2. And they try to get Pujols to chase here, but he lays off. It's 1-2.
Boy, he sped him up in this at bat. Now it's time for the changeup. This guy's got a good one, and he hasn't thrown it yet in this at bat.
One-two offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2.
Don't be surprised if he gets another back foot slider right here. Don't think for a second, just because he took the first one, that this pitcher won't come back exactly the same way.
The 2-2. Fly ball out toward left center field. Under it is Hayes, and that's the first out of the inning.
Now batting the catcher, Jason Castro.
So striding in, Jason Castro. He was drilled by a pitch his last time up.
Yeah, Matty, you're not lying. Last time up, squared right in the back. Hopefully it doesn't stiffen up. I want to see if he can get through something right here.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Oh, and he just blows the fastball by him for strike one. Castro is currently third in the league amongst catchers in all-star fan balloting.
Yeah, and you don't want to leave it up to a manager's decision. You want to get in based on the fan vote, and he has a chance to do exactly that if he can make a late push as we head towards the Midsummer Classic.
Mancini in a few steps as he takes it, two down.
The bat, number two, shortstop, Andrelton Simmons.
Back to the top of the order now, and standing in one of the best two-strike hitters in baseball, Andrelton Simmons. He's ready. Here's the first offering.
Nope. Ball one.
Two men are on with two men out. Lazy fly ball out to center field. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. Angels strand a couple. Still down 3-0. Riding in once again, Chris Davis. He went deep in his first at bat. We'll see what he's got in store for us here.
Well, Matt, this is one of the problems. This guy's a good fastball, particularly low fastball hitter. It doesn't matter how hard or how low you throw it. That's right into this wheelhouse. What you want to do with this guy is move the ball from the belt up to get him to chase something that maybe he'll pop up in the infield.
Now here it comes. And he goes against the shift there as this is on the ground to the left side.
Boy, so frustrating as a pitcher. You make a quality pitch on the inside half of the plate right there. Try to bust him in, D-Row, and he fights it off the other way.
Yeah, you tip your hat to the pitcher right there. He executed his pitch, but nice job by the offensive player fighting. It doesn't matter what it looks like. A knock's a knock.
So it's back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring up the shortstop, Jose Iglesias. From the belt, kicks and deals. Down and away, one ball and no strikes. The 1-0. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Trout has a read on it, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning.
Up next for the Orioles, the second baseman, Romo Urias.
Striding into the box, Ramon Urias. It was a single for him in his last at bat. First pitch of the at bat. Comes set with the 0-1. On a rope to the second baseman, and the runner gets back. No double play.
It's really important to be a second baseman and have some athletic ability. And how about this right here? He goes up high to snag this line drive that was definitely headed to the outfield for a base hit.
So two are gone now in the Baltimore fifth, and that'll bring up the power hitting outfielder Trey Mancini. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Two out with the man at first. There's the fastball that gets the lower part of the zone called for a strike. Hit hard up the middle, and that finds its way through for a base hit.
Boy, after that base knock right there, D-Row, he extends his hitting streak to 7 games.
Yeah, and you can tell he's made some necessary adjustments at the plate. Anytime you're getting a knock every day of the week, you're doing things right. He's keeping that front shoulder tucked, staying inside the ball, not trying to do too much.
On his way toward the mound now is skipper Joe Maddon. And it would appear he's seen enough of his starter this afternoon. So he'll depart here in the fifth after working just 4 2/3. And he's on the hook for the L unless this one turns around. Jaime Barilla trots in from the bullpen here as he inherits a tough spot with two on and two away. And here's Renato Nunez. He'll look at a fastball in there on the outer half. It's 0-1. He's hitless in his two at bats so far. Trying to hang a zero. Here's the pitch. Two down, runners at first and second. A 2-1 count to Nunez. Barilla, a 6'1" right-hander. He's in his third season as a major league player. Now the 2-1 pitch. There's a drive high in the air and deep to left center field. And this is going to wind up as extra bases as that'll play one for sure and maybe a second.
When this thing left his bat, I started thinking it might have enough to get out of here. Didn't quite carry enough, but it does one hop the wall off the track, and he cruises into second with an RBI two-bagger. You'll take that every day of the week.
So now to the plate, Dwight Smith Jr., as he'll pop this one foul off to the left and out of play. No hits to this point. Ready with the nothing and one pitch. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Well above the letters with the fastball that time. And now we see a right-hander up and throwing in the Angel bullpen. The 1-2. Swing and a miss as he chases one out of the zone for the third strike, and that's the third out of the inning. Orioles get a run on the RBI double. We're through five here this afternoon. It's now 4-0 Baltimore. Ready now for LA, David Fletcher. He'll start things out in the sixth for a lineup that really hasn't found its groove in this one.
Yeah, only two hits so far, Matt, and not very many hard hit balls either. We'll see if they can start making some adjustments.
First pitch of the at bat on its way. Fastball in there for a called strike.
That elevated fastball right there, that is the biggest change in the game today for me. When I first came up, a lot of guys working that Greg Maddux east to west.
Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball. The 1-1 home.
That's in. Ball two. That's ball three.
Time to wake up the offense right here. 3-1 count, all in on something over the heart of the plate.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes.
I
tough pitch to lay off, but he did, and it's ball four, so the leadoff hitter is aboard to start the sixth.
Yeah, and as a starter, the last thing you want to do is let a team answer when your guys just scored a run for you. So he's thinking ground ball right here to try to get a double play and end this threat.
In now is Anthony Rendon, 0 for 2 on his line thus far. First offering on its way. Sent in the air out to straightaway central. Under it is Hayes, and that's the first out of the inning.
The batter, the center fielder, Mike Trout.
Here's the center fielder, Mike Trout. He was a ground out victim last time up.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result. That's his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
Runner at first here, one man out. Fooled pretty badly there as he reaches to poke this one foul. Hit hard to short. Iglesias is there to second for one. On to first. It's a double play as their woes continue. The inning is over. Angels held in check there. They trail here 4-0. Bottom of the sixth inning now. Trying to pick things up where we left off. Anthony Santander. He's coming off a solo homer in his previous trip.
And that last at bat when he went deep, he turned around a pretty good fastball. So I'm kind of thinking this guy's a good fastball hitter. So I might want to move that ball up and down and in and out and try not to throw it right down the middle of the plate.
The 0-1 is a fastball low, and that evens the count at 1-1. Here it comes.
Ball, that's out.
Lifted down the line and left. And this will wind up a foul ball. Here now the 2-2 is looked at and the count moves full. A swing and a high drive to right center field. Back goes Trout to the track and it's gone as they add still another. Solo shot to right center. His second home run of the game as the Orioles have opened things up now 5-0.
Second home run of the game right there. He is locked in at the plate. You hear so many of today's players talk about rhythm and timing. Well, he is perfectly on time in the heart of the zone.
Stepping in now, Austin Hayes. Yes, he'll take a tough pitch on the outside part of the plate for strike one. Two hits and two trips for him thus far. A windup and the 0-1.
Your idea of working the count goes out the window. You're frustrated right now. Down 0-2. Got to find a way to grind.
Nothing in two count and the pitch. Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1-2.
Man, that's a good take there on that 0-2 fastball just missed. He must have a really good eye at the plate.
Ripped down the line, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. There's ball two as the slider dips below the zone. slapped hard the opposite way. And again, he's got himself a base hit. Make it 3 for 3.
They talk about having a day. How about 3 at-bats, 3 knocks? Not a bad day, D-Row.
We used to say in the big leagues on the bench, anybody can get 2. Can you get 3? And if you get 3, who's on the hook for 4?
In now, Austin wins. As he'll take a look at a slider here that misses for ball 1. 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. The 1-0. A swing and a miss. That's the first strike. Nobody out, runner on first. A bullet to first base. And they'll put the tag on him heading back to first. It's a double play.
Number 19. Chris Davis.
Digging in and looking for more, Chris Davis. He singled his last time up. He's ready. Here's the first offering.
You can bet he wants that one back at the plate right now. That's a pitch you normally see a guy drive if he has the right approach going.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And it's belted high and deep into right center. Trout looks up. Into the bleachers and gone. So a big home run for him, certainly. Number 300 for his career.
Well, you have to appreciate what he's been able to do in his career, guys. He's truly established himself as one of the great power hitters in the game today, and this is a milestone he can be really proud of. And there are a lot of very good hitters that never got 300 dingers in their career.
To the plate now, Jose Iglesias. As he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike 1. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. Here's the 0-1. Ball 1, as that one didn't really threaten the inside corner. One and one, here it comes. And he takes one off the inside corner for ball 2. Even count, 2 balls and 2 strikes. Shin high fastball that time, ball 3.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Hit on the ground out to short. Simmons has it. Throw over to Pujols at first. He'll take care of him to end the inning. Another good inning for the O's. Fans like it, too. On to the back third here this afternoon, and we'll have it for you next on MLB Network. Striding forward now is the DH. Tommy La Stella. He comes in 0 for 2 thus far.
It doesn't look very promising so far in this one as we move into the later innings. Down by a bundle, it's time to get some base runners and hopefully a long ball to get them back into this one.
And the first pitch of the inning here misses down and in for a ball. It's 1-0. Now here it comes.
2-0.
You know, sometimes it takes a pitcher a few pitches to get going, but those two pitches weren't even close. Ball's behind in the count, 2-0. It's time to start getting locked in.
The 2-0 on the way. A swing and a miss, strike one.
That swing had one purpose, and that was to put the ball over the wall. I guess he doesn't have much to lose with his team down this many at this point in the game.
This is hit the other way out toward left field. Santander's got it, and there's one away. Justin Upton, the next to hit, comes into this one with just one hit in nine tries for the series. First pitch on its way to Upton. Bases are empty, one man out. Now a swing and a deep drive to right. And it's gone into the bleachers. Justin Upton with the solo home run. Sixth home run on the season for him. And they're on the board at 6-1.
What a great feeling right there as he circles the pillows, finally able to get this offense potentially going with one swing of the bat, being shut out all game, but not anymore.
Next batter to the plate, Brian Goodwin. As the first pitch to him is swung on and missed for strike one.
We're moving right along into this one. This guy's continuing to pitch well, which is a little bit of a surprise because his first pitch strike ratio is still under 60%.
The 0-1 on its way. Looks like a lefty and a right-hander throwing in the Baltimore bullpen. One out, nobody on. Inside, as that perhaps will back him off a bit. 1-2.
Well, this is an approach we've seen him use effectively lately. Set up the inside and then get him out with pitches away.
1-2, here it comes.
Got to take advantage of that pitch right there. 0-2 breaker hanging over the heart of the plate. Not going to see too many of those today.
Lifted the other way out to left center. Chasing after it is Santander. He's got it. A nice play there. Two away. Ready for another shot now. Albert Pujols, 0-2 on the afternoon so far. First pitch of the at bat on its way. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1.
Nope.
That's over, but low, it's a ball and a strike.
Hey, there's not a lot you can do with a slider breaking down and in unless you catch it way out front. I like the idea of taking it and making the pitcher bring you something a little more hittable.
Two balls and a strike to the Angels' first baseman. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. Now here's the pitch.
Helpful.
One of the things you want to do with a starter, get that pitch count up. Here's another productive at bat, as this count now gets to 3 balls and 2 strikes.
Now the payoff pitch home. And they don't even want to mess with Pujols here with a base open, so they'll go ahead and put him aboard.
Well, when you've been out there as long as he has, you have to expect to lose a little precision in your location. He's up over 90 pitches now, so he might be starting to tire a little bit. Something to keep an eye on.
Here comes the Baltimore skipper out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And we're going to have a pitching change, as that's going to be all for his starter this afternoon. So he receives a nice ovation from this home crowd, departing after surrendering just one earned run. Hector Velasquez takes over here with a runner at first and two gone in the inning.
Number 75, Hector Velasquez.
Jason Castro will be the first to greet him here as he stands in with a runner at first and two away. From the stretch, here's the pitch. A shot down the first baseline. The 0-1 delivery. And here's one that misses to the Angel catcher. It's back even at 1-1. Ball and two strikes to the Angels catcher.
You have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a bruised shin or a ground out to the left side.
And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. So it may be too little too late, but they're on the board here in the late going. Bottom of the seventh inning coming up. Get up and stretch. It's the Orioles 6 and the Angels 1. Matt Andrees gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh. Last half of the seventh here, striding in, Ramon Urias. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. A fastball off the plate away. It's ball one. Some stirring now in that Angel bullpen, as it'll be both a lefty and a righty that start to get loose. The 1-0. Line towards center field. He dives. Did he catch that? He did. What a play there for the first out.
I suppose this is why you usually have the best defensive outfielder in center field. He got a good read on it, charges in hard, and made a fabulous grab. Look for that one to make the highlight reels later on.
So here's Trey Mancini. Here comes the first pitch. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1. There's a ball low. He misses with a changeup. And that's taken up and in for ball two. Now the 2-1 pitch. Ball even at 2-2. And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away.
Hey, I'm not sure what he was sitting on right there. Might have been sitting on an off-speed pitch, but instead he gets the fastball way late. Had no chance to put that ball in play.
Into the box, Renato Nunez. Takes this the other way to right, and that'll get down for a two-out single.
Guys, that jacks me up right there. Kept his front shoulder tucked, the hip tucked, was able to stay inside that slider and drive it the other way.
To the plate now is the designated hitter, Dwight Smith Jr. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. is set, and the pitch. A runner on first with two away. Good breaking ball there, laid off for the second strike. Breaking ball, that's in the dirt as he takes a ball.
Hey, the fish ain't biting there on that 0-2 breaking ball, but you got to be careful because this pitcher might throw him another one.
Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. One left for the Orioles. They hold on to their 6-1 lead. In now is Andrelton Simmons. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Now a changeup, but it misses just a little below the zone. And now a right-hander up and throwing in the Baltimore bullpen. Hit well down the left field line, but back into the crowd foul. Angel shortstop behind in the count at a ball and two strikes.
Well, they've really had an answer for keeping him in check in this series. He's offered very little resistance with the bat in his hand so far.
Heading out toward shallow right. Therefore, it is Mancini, and that's the first out of the inning. With that, we'll give you a look at our starter comparison for the two starting pitchers in the game, and the column to look at is the one on the right side of your screen. Not too many hits to go around at this point in the ballgame. Digging in, David Fletcher, 0-for-2 here to start the afternoon. From the stretch. Now here's a bouncing ball headed for Iglesias at short. In time to first, and there are two away. Now at the plate, Anthony Rendon. He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Ball one.
I think when a team starts struggling, certainly offensively, it's just guys try and play above their pay grade. Know who the best players are in the lineup and try and get on base to set them up.
The 1-0. There's an off-speed pitch taken for a ball.
He may be down 2-0 after those first two pitches in this AB, but those are pitches he can feel pretty good about. They did miss by a whole lot, so it's not like he's all over the place.
Two out, nobody on. There's the cold strike he was looking for. 2-2 now. Now here it comes. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. Angels are gone in order. They trail 6-1. In now for the O's, Anthony Santander. He comes in 2-for-3 with a couple of home runs thus far on his line.
Yeah, in his last at-bat, he hit a changeup out for a home run, so it'll be interesting this AB to see if they give him a steady diet of fastballs.
Strike one to start the at-bat. Set up away with the changeup, but it's 1-1. With this one almost in books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Well, Matty V, I don't know what your thoughts are, D-Roll, but boy, when the weather starts to warm up and the ball starts jumping out like this, it's clear that the pitchers need to start making better pitches.
Yeah, just great approach. No one really chased today. Really stayed staunch on their ability to get that pitcher to come into the heart of the plate, and they did damage with it.
Austin Hayes will be next. Swung on and missed 3-2. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. In the air out to center field. Trout is under this one. One down. Stepping into the box, Austin Hayes. Last time through was a base hit. First pitch of the at bat on its way. Runs up to bunt here, but he missed it for strike one. Bases are empty, one man out. Swing and a miss, and he's in trouble now, 0-2. Inside, as he might be trying to set him up here, 1-2.
That turns out to be a good take on that front door breaking ball, but you have to wonder if that pitch buckled him at all. That was really close to clipping the inside corner.
The 1-2.
Oh, that's off the plate. Ball two.
Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field.
I mean, obviously, this guy is built to play in the daytime. 4-for-4, you know he's seeing it good right now. These are the days that you remember for a long time.
At the plate now, Austin wins as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. And he hasn't quite had the same fortune at the plate as many of his teammates. No hits for him so far. Taken. Now it's 0-2.
Surprised the pitcher would even go to the top of the zone looking for a double play in this situation.
Ready on 0-2. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes.
If you've got a good fastball going and they're not handling, keep throwing it. Right there, three fastballs in a row. He gone.
Here's Chris Davis now, as the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. Two home runs already to his name in this one, and we'll see if he could possibly strike again. Now the 1-0. Line drive, base hit to right. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Man, talk about having a good game. Like most guys, this would be a good week. Fourth hit of the game. And two of those D-Rolls round trippers.
Yeah, he's going to have a smile on his face for a while here, Dan. These are special nights. You have to enjoy these. These don't come around often, and he is taking full advantage of it.
Struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. The 1-0 is offered at and missed for the first strike. Two balls and a strike to the Orioles leadoff hitter.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot he's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
Popped up, Pujols in foul ground, but this will land untouched. Here now the 2-2. And this one's in the dirt. Good job to corral this quickly as the runners hold on. High in the air out to center field. Trout has a read on it. Makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. Orioles strand a couple. They lead it 6-1. Richard Bleier comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth. All set to start the ninth in this one. Into the box now. Mike Trout has got a hit in three at-bats to this point. First delivery to him on the way.
Hey, there's an old saying in baseball, you need to take a strike in this spot. Well, he got one there. Now he just needs to find a way to get on.
Counts even to Trout, 1-1. Bleier is a reliever known for forcing contact. Not a huge strikeout guy most of the time, but he also doesn't issue a lot of free passes either.
There's a couple of keys to being a good reliever. One, if you have great stuff and you strike everybody out, or like this guy, not afraid to throw the ball in the strike zone. He has good stuff, not great stuff. He's not afraid to let his defense help him out and make some plays.
To third, he's got it. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway. Now batting, Tommy La Stella. He flew out in his last at bat. He's set. Here it comes. Lefty against lefty here as this is taken for a ball. 1-0. That one's a called strike. Back even at one. Movement in the Orioles bullpen now as they've got a left-hander up and throwing. In there at the letters, 1-2 now.
Hey, it looks like this guy's going to work in the upper part of the strike zone. It'll be interesting to see if this lineup can adjust to the way he pitches.
The 1-2. Grounded weakly to the left. Reined in. And the off-balance throw gets him. Nice play for the out. Standing in, Justin Upton. And he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the ninth.
It'll be interesting to see if they use that changeup in this at-bat. That last at-bat, that was a changeup he hit for a home run. I'm going to see if this time they don't go to more fastballs and curveballs.
And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0. Upton. Or simply J-Up. He was a first-round pick back in 2005.
Yeah, he has turned himself into a really nice ball player. I wouldn't put him on the superstar level, but you know what? They didn't miss with this pick either. You go into high rounds and you carve out a career the way this guy has, nice pick.
The Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. A crowd of over 39,000 on their feet. Breaking ball well inside and taken for ball three. Bases are empty here with two men out. Angels down to their last strike. Line drive to left. And Upton's aboard. It's a base hit. Throw into second.
Well, he was definitely struggling coming into this one, but I think we could say that cold streak is officially over. That's his second hit of the game, and it goes for extra bases. We'll see now if this game proves to be a huge turning point for him.
Standing in now, Brian Goodwin. As the first pitch sinker misses to him, it's ball one. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. That's wide, 2-0. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. Now a ball lined to the left side. Foul. And just never could commit to the swing there, but he went around and it's even now at 2-2. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. Now a swing and a fly ball. And this should do it. And that's going to fall for a base hit. And they're not going to get him. He's in there at the plate. He's in at second safely as a run will score on the play as well. So now to the plate, Albert Pujols. Hangs on him a bit that time as it's belted out toward deep center field. Into the bleachers and out of here. Albert Pujols, a two-run shot. Fourth home run for him on the season. And they cut the gap here. It's now 6-4. Well, that's the sixth home run we've watched leave the yard in this one. Guys, what do you think's behind the hitting we've seen here today?
Dan, they're absolutely knocking the cover off the ball. I'm curious to get your take on this. I didn't find it to be the truth. I didn't mind hitting at night. But a lot of guys say they see the ball better during the day.
You know what's funny, D-Row, is I preferred to pitch in night games as opposed to day games. I always thought it was advantage to the hitter, and so far that looks like it's the case in this one right here. They must be seeing the ball really well because they're just absolutely smoking the baseball right now.
Stepping in now, Jason Castro. No balls and one strike. Three runs already home here. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Two out, two strike offering. Here it is. In the dirt, but swung on and missed. Throw one to first, and the Orioles have run their winning streak to 5 in a row now as this ball game is over.
Yeah, that's the way you want to finish a 3-game home series. Breaking out the brooms and sweeping the other guys right out of here.
6-4, the outcome today. Baltimore led this game from the third inning on and never wavered. Keegan Aiken notches his third win of the year. So that's a wrap for us in this one. Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, Matt Vasgersian, we all thank you for watching Major League Baseball on MLB Network. See you next time.